Hello my dear students, I hope you all are very very fine. Today we are going to discuss chapter 6 digestion, and in this video we are going to discuss short and long question answer because the explanation of our chapter is over. So we are going to discuss question answer. So let's start without a delay. First question is, what happens to the food in the mouth? The answer is, food is broken down into smaller pieces by teeth and get mixed with the saliva with the help of the tongue, and after that it is pushed to the food pipe, okay, with the help of tongue again. So this question is asking, after taking the food just in the mouth, what happened there? So in the mouth it is broken down into the smaller pieces and it is mixed with the saliva, in a simple language, and after that, after few seconds, it is pushed towards the stomach with the help of the food pipe. So you can write this answer in your own language also. Question number 2 is, what happens to the food in the stomach? Okay, the stomach is the second part where the food is passed to, okay, and there it remains for 3 to 4 hours, and all these 3 to 4 hours it used to churn and mix with the several digestive juices which is secreted by the wall of the small intestine. Okay, so that only happen in the stomach. It used to churn means food get mixed, okay, and move back and forth and get mixed with the digestive juices very nicely. So let's read the answer. Food remains for 3 to 4 hours in the stomach. During this time period, food is churned and mixed with the several digestive juices. These digestive juices break down the proteins, okay, mainly protein is broken down in the stomach. Question number 3 is, where does the digested food go from the stomach? The line will the answer will be in a single line, that digested food go to the small intestine from the stomach. Nothing you have to write much in this answer. Number 4 is, what is the first step of digestion? When I was explaining the process of the digestion, that time I told you digestion can be categorized into 4 steps. First is ingestion, second is digestion, third is absorption, and last is egestion. So the first step of the digestion is called ingestion. If you don't know this word or you forget this word, then you can also write, the first step of that digestion is to take the food into the mouth, okay, because ingestion means taking the food into the mouth only. So if you are not recalling this word ingestion, that sentence also you can write, that will be also absolutely right. Next we are going to discuss is how food is taken to all the part of the body. That means after the food is get digested in the small intestine, how it is transported to each and every part of our body. So it is transported with the help of the blood. Okay, in the small intestine, the digestion of the food is completed, and after that it is absorbed by the blood vessels which is present in the wall on the wall of the small intestine. So you have to just write, food is taken to all parts with the help of the blood. Now next we are going to discuss long answer questions. Question number 1 is, name 4 organs of the digestive system which make digestive juices. Okay, you just have to write the name of the organ which secrete digestive juices. You can write mouth, okay, where the saliva is secreted. It will be better if you are writing salivary gland, that is also correct. Second, in this stomach also digestive juices are secreted by the wall of this stomach. Third, liver is also secreting digestive juices. 4, pancreas are also secreting, and small intestine also used to secrete digestive juices. So you just have to write 4 organ which used to secrete digestive juices. I have written also what type of digestive juices are secreted by the liver or pancreas, but if you want to skip this, you can skip, but it will be better if you are writing this, okay? Mainly you have to mention the name of the organs which secrete the digestive juices. Okay, let's read the answer. Four organs of digestive system which make digestive juices are mouth, liver, pancreas and small intestine. Next question is asking, explain digestion of food in small intestine. This question you have to explain what happened in the small intestine. See, from the stomach, the food is going to the small intestine, and in the small intestine, two functions are occurred. Okay, keep in the mind. First, digestion is completed, and second, the food is get absorbed into the blood. Okay, these two functions you have to keep in the mind, and according to that, you have to explain. So, digestion is completed okay in the small intestine, and what happened here, the digestive juices from the liver and from the pancreas is also coming, okay, and getting mixed with the digestive juices which is secreted by the small intestine itself, and after that it is broken down into the smaller pieces, and here only the digestion is completed, and after getting digested, the blood cells which is present in the wall, in the inside of the wall of small intestine, there these nutrients are get absorbed. Okay, so let's read what the answer is saying. Small intestine produce digestive juices and also receives digestive juices from liver, that is bile, and pancreas, that is pancreatic juices. These juices help to digest the food completely. Finally, digested food is absorbed into blood through the wall of the small intestine. This only you have to write, but please keep in the mind two functions you have to explain, digestion and absorption. Next we are going to discuss is what happens to the food in the large intestine. Simply keep in the mind, in the large intestine the water and minerals are absorbed from the undigested food. You all are knowing, just now I have discussed, the digestion is completed in the small intestine, and after that whatever food is passed to the large intestine is the simply waste, that is undigested food. And from that all the minerals and water is also absorbed, and this process forms feces. Okay, so this only you have to write. Main word in this answer is the absorption of water and minerals from the undigested food, and it depends upon you how you frame the answer. Let's read the answer. Large intestine contains undigested food from which water and minerals are absorbed through the wall of large intestine. Absorption of water results in the formation of feces. Next we are going to discuss is write down any four good eating habits. First of all, 7 to 8 points are given in your book that you can write, or you can add your own points also, because you are knowing we are following so many good health eating habits. Okay, you can include the general eating habit that you used to follow in your daily life. Okay, what I have written, let's read. First I have written, we should always eat balanced diet. Second, we should not overeat. We should always wash our hand before and after eating. Last, we should eat covered food at clean and tidy places. You can also write that we should rinse our mouth after every meal. You can also write we should include two glasses of the milk every day. Okay, because that is the complete food. Or you can also write we should add green vegetables in our food. It depends upon you what points you are writing. I hope this video will help you to complete your question answer. Thank you for watching.